you know?
Yeah, like, made me think of that Beatles song, How's It Feel to Be One of the Beautiful People? You know, like, I don't know. Yeah, it's like, everyday ordinary people, I mean, that's a strange thing to say. It feels strange for me to say it, but the term came to mind as it's a good way to put what I'm trying to think of. But everyday ordinary people just sitting there, and then they, like he was just saying in that song, so-called beautiful people and all. I mean, that's a lie, too. I mean, nobody's more beautiful than another.
We're beautiful people, man. That's why I think everyone's beautiful.
Everybody's beautiful. That's your point. Yeah. You know, we're beautiful. Y'all are beautiful. Everyone is.
That's a good thing.
And,
how does it feel, though?
How does it feel, you know? But it's just like, I could just see, man. Psychically, I can see so much right now. It's just it's strange. I'm trying to decide if it's best to talk about it now or should we continue? We'll keep talking. I just see a lot. Like, I can just see things coming up, you know?
Yeah.
I can see the way I'll be. I'll admit sometimes, like, let me say this. Like, if y'all call and don't get an answer, please leave a message. You know, because sometimes a number comes up and then that's it. I don't know who it is. I don't want to call back. If it's been hours, I don't call back. There's not a message. But please leave a message. If you're trying to get in touch, leave a message.
Yeah.
Or at least say, I called about this. I'm doing so. Call. Don't be afraid to. I mean, we're trying to do things good. I mean, we're not going to put out a bunch of BS or anything like that.
No.
It's just, like what we were talking about yesterday, like, I'm not, you know, if it's truth, it's truth. Like we talked about yesterday in the videos for the 20th, in part one in the 1 hour split up section. Like, I was talking about, you know, how I feel, you know, just going through this and, like, just stepping through that door for real, you know? And, like, I'm thinking about the city. I was seeing the Richmond, Virginia, and different neighborhoods and all the varieties of thought and people.
Yeah, I feel you on that, man. Definitely feel you on that.
You do see that?
Yeah. I think about that. Being helpful, you know, to the city immediately, you know.
Yeah.
Doing the best we can, you know what I'm saying, here. You know, things go outward, like life.
Yeah.
You know, let it happen. You know, that's what's going to happen. I see it happening. You know.
I'm just going to see that support that would start here in Richmond.
Yeah.
You know, if something tells me, like, don't worry about getting out of Richmond right now. Just plant some seeds here. We've been here a long time. It's time to help people.
Yeah. It's like the seed, you know, right here in the core or something.
Plant some seeds around here. Some seeds of love.
Yeah.
Plant the seeds of love. That's another song. It's good.
Yeah, it was that one.
Tears for Fears. Sowing the Seeds of Love.
Yeah.
I had that song in the car on one of my CDs. Good song. Maybe we'll play it sometime on here. If YouTube wants censored, like they did try to put the song on.
Well, that's other
times.
I don't know.
I forget it. We'll not worry about it.
But you know, you can look it up.
You look it up, but yeah, that's a great song.
Oh,
Sowing
yeah.
the Seeds of Love.
Cheers
look
for
it
fears.
Up
good.
On YouTube or whatever.
Good group, man.
But I'm just trying to sow some seeds of love. That is true.
Yeah.
You know, we do it a different way than most people. Like, this is not an attack on churches or anything, but what I got to say is this. Like, there's a difference between going out there and actually doing something and asking God to do it for you.
Yeah.
Or praying, do this, Jesus, kind of help us. And sometimes, like, the infinite is waiting for you to take that first step. And then you're going to get the help you're looking for. But sometimes, I think almost every time it could be like that. You have to take the first step.
Yeah, you have to, jump off the edge, you know what I mean? Not literally, metaphorically, you know, but, you know, kind of like take that leap of faith, you know. Sometimes just like love is not always easy, you know. Life is not always easy, you know. But you should, you know, be easy with yourself and live your life, you know, do what you need to do. Live those dreams, though, you know, is what I mean. You know, like, if you go in the direction you decide you want to live that dream, you know, you go ahead and take that pain, you know, go through it, man. You know, get that ball rolling, and it'll start going in the direction that you need it to be.
That's right. It's why I want to see this each and every one of y'all like turn out to be successful in what you love to do.
Yeah.
And he does too. And, you know, even if you feel like you don't have any skills or any useful things you could do, you do have something useful. You just got to look, maybe have to look a little hard, but it's there within you.
Yeah, you know, exactly. You have a goal, you know, in yourself.
It is in there. But sometimes you just have to do it. You can't let yourself be talked out of it, for example, by your own mind.
Yeah.
Like if your dream is to, whatever, it could be, your dream is to be famous as a somebody, whoever it is, famous as a writer, or to say that,
mm-hmm.
famous as a rapper, famous as an actor, whatever it is.
Yeah.
If you know you're good at it, you just have to go out and represent knowing you're good at it with your heart, without a doubt. And it's the only way I can describe it.
Yeah, there's no, you know, and really, again, what you're good at, you know, whatever it is, you know, just want you to follow your heart, you know. And even it could be down to the guys who like to chop trees down.
Yeah.
You know, whatever.
If you like doing that, it's all right.
Yeah, do it. You know,
that's part of freedom.
Yeah, that's the thing, you know. You know, but some people just do it to get by, you know, and have a lot of other things built up inside that could really be something. And I think everybody almost seems to have this situation going on somewhere in them, you know.
They all think that they can't do what they love.
Yeah.
But you can do what you love. You know, but then people might be like, well, who's going to do the work no one else wants to do?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, I think at the point, if you're really doing things you love to do, helping people and helping your society or your world even, I think it'd probably become part of it. It's a very good likelihood. So you're going to maybe even want to do it yourself, the stuff that no one else wants to do. You know what, there might be thousands of volunteers stepping up for that in a world of things like that.
Yeah.
You know, like we're ready to help. We'll do that too. We'll do what we love, and we love doing this.
Yeah, exactly.
It would be done. So,
yeah.
I trust us. I just know it can be done. Yeah. I'm just saying, you have to trust me on this, but it can be done.
Yeah.
Trust him. Trust me. It can be done.
Like I said, maybe we can't say that with living examples or words, you know, but the words are important. We're doing the best we can now, you know.
We live it as close as possible. You know, it's perfect, you know.
Right.
You know, because I know how important it is, you know, when you need an example, when you're teaching something, you need to represent what you're teaching to the best of your ability.
Exactly.
You can't just emptily say, do this and that without showing your own effort, get in there.
Yeah, you know, you're going to live to be something or be a way. You know, you should be that way all the time, you know. Because if you dabble in who you are with different people, it'll come back to you, you know.
Yes, you can't worry about it, like, find what you love. Whatever it is, find what you love and do it and move into it and keep doing it even if people laugh at you.
Those are evident words, not mine. I'm going to just say that.
Which words? The one you just said?
Well, the one that I said about the dabbling. You know what I mean? Whatever. I can't even remember what I said now.
I remember you talking about dabbling. I don't remember all either. But we're on tape.
Yeah.
So let me check and be sure it's recording right.
Yeah.
That I'm sure it is, but I'll always double check.